we've got we're opening up our 11th practice on Saturday. We're a group of 11 practices. I've tried to build numerous types of businesses, you know, bookkeeping, graphic designing, and all of them failed. So they wouldn't hire you or invest. The venture capitalists wouldn't even look at a business if you haven't failed before. And I mean, that's a process of gathering information and changing.
So, like I said, I think there's a lot of value. I recently saw your post on, I think it's Instagram and Facebook, or one of the social media platforms or platform. And you spoke about your origin story, where you started, the struggles of starting your business. It wasn't always like it's right now, and like building and working on your business and not in your business. Right then it was actually being...
Yeah.
Working in your business and not on it. So I think take us to start with people that don't know you. Share with us your origin story as you started.
Yeah, sure. Thanks. I think I've always been entrepreneurial. In primary school, I started making cigarettes out of my mom's tea and then selling that at the later stage. I probably wasn't in the right school. And then in high school, I started a printing business on champagne bottles to provide it to dealer principals or dealerships for cars. And that continued into university, and I studied optometry to become an optometrist. And then I went totally medical and lost it for business. Started practicing in Johannesburg, and then I noticed that people keep on breaking their glasses. We were then a group of friends that came together once a week to discuss... To discuss different business ideas, and I had this idea of creating a business eyewear insurance product. So by grace, I don't know how I got startup funding. I started the business. We built up a product, got over 200 customers. We had 10 employees, worked at it, and you know, we launched within 5 months the product working with insurers, which was amazing. And then I lost that business literally overnight. When one of my customers decided that they as a group would be they will do the product themselves. So we lost a big part of our business at that point. And although we've raised 3 rounds of funding, we couldn't sustain it anymore. But what that learned me, that you know, by selling and going to our customers, which was optometrists at that time, it enabled me to have a lot of conversations with optometrists and hearing all of the problems that they have. And the entrepreneur, as one is, you look for solutions for those problems. So for each one of them, like you also do, I try and build solutions for each one of those problems. And I always thought, how would it look like if I combined all of these products together? So once I lost my startup after the initial 3 years, there was a practice for sale in Johannesburg for 200,000 rand, and I always got these SMSs that said, you know, Capitec or whoever will loan you 200,000 rand, and I thought 1 and 1 is 2. So did a personal loan, bought the practice, very stupid in that sense that I didn't know that you need money for cash flow and stock and advertising and, you know, changing the shop front. So, you know, I had to extend my credit and my wife's credit to get that business running. And it was a big struggle in the beginning. Although we had a few, you know, the right vision, practically making the business work was very difficult. And we live in St. Paul. That business is in Sandton. So I had to flew in for months, week in, week out. I couldn't afford accommodation. So I had to sleep in the practice, in the testing consulting room. There was a sleeper couch. There was an aircon. And we didn't have showers, so above us there was a boxing gym. So I had to take boxing lessons to use the showers.
Thank you for watching. Just a quick reminder to grab your gift bag for entrepreneurs in the link below. It's a gift bag for entrepreneurs to the value of 57,000 rand, free of charge. All you need to do is activate it. Part of that gift bag for entrepreneurs is a voucher of 3 months for 3 months free accounting services from a company, Dryk Holdings. All you need to do is activate the gift bag voucher in the link below, and we will be in contact with you as soon as you've done that. thank you for watching, and back to the interview.
Which was also very interesting. So we continued doing that, and it was so important working in the business and that compound because the customers now is not optometrists, it's patients, you know, it needs glasses and learning to understand what they needed. And so from there on, I went to build, I started with a group of friends, also a barbershop, which became three barbershops, serving, I think, over 2,000 customers per month. And then I sold that after 2 years. The past 3 years of 1,000 days, that was what the post was about. I've tried to build numerous types of businesses, bookkeeping, graphic designing, and I've learned that, and all of them failed. And I've learned that it's very important to keep to what you know, your industry, and know your industry very well. So a year and a half back, we turned all of our focus just towards optique and our group, and we franchised it. And the focus made a huge, huge difference, and partnering with the right people. Today we're opening up our 11th practice on Saturday. We're a group of 11 practices, six of which I own, and then there's five franchises, and we hope to grow even more, serving the community, because that's actually the main focus of a business, is not generating profit necessarily, but enough profit to make it rewardable for the owner and serve the community. So we're excited about that.
A number of exciting points to actually take our conversation to. There's a number of other ideas I also have, but like I said to you in the beginning, just before we go, I really want to do this in the flow of what even need to come out today, need to come out. So I think the very first thing that's always inspiring to me for any startup entrepreneur, especially a failing entrepreneur, in the sense of or his failures, not a failing entrepreneur, but his failures, is you always get that opportunity of growth in that time of difficulty. If it wasn't for your first failure and the clients that actually stole your business from you, you wouldn't be able to start Optik and be where you are today, because you gained so much knowledge from that experience. So I've been through similar kind of business failures, and it's always in hindsight, you always see these great opportunities that was there, and sometimes you take it and sometimes you don't. I think it all depends on how you look at the current situation we are in. So do you agree with me, like, in the sense of every young guy need to go through, especially guys, because our egos tend to be a bit big. So every young guy need to go through a business failure as quickly and as young as possible.
Yes, absolutely. I think it's part of our South African culture to shy away from failure, but it is, in my opinion, absolutely impossible to get from point A to B without the road between point A and B is failure. A friend of mine, he was honored to get with Investec to go over to the Startup Valley, in Silicon Valley in California. One of the things that they looked at as a startup entrepreneur is what have you failed in? So they wouldn't hire you or invest. The venture capitalists wouldn't even look at a business if you haven't failed before. And I mean, that's a process of gathering information and changing. Just as a human, any live organism does exactly that. So as an entrepreneur, failure is actually the sense of being aware exactly what changes to do. And it's not a bad thing at all. You know, I really find success in the fact that we can fail. You have to be comfortable with failing, because it happens every day. There's micro failures and there's macro failures, but you have to be comfortable in it. Absolutely.
Any two ideas of value, two tips of value?
Two tips of value, I think, for startup entrepreneurs is to get psychologically comfortable with failing and doing, you know, persistence. So persistence is probably one of the major key points in business, but also not having a mentor, not being stupid in persistence, knowing when the business is doomed to fail, it's also really important.